how is the closure market in India now? Is it what's the volume kind of thing? Do you, have well, you made a kind of survey?
Actually, there is some standard volume. I can estimate, perhaps I'm wrong, but I can estimate that perhaps we are talking about something around in the small volumes, something around 350, something between 350, 400 million cups per month. We, as Alicia Torrent, we are producing here now in Alicia Torrent more than 100 million cups per month.
Okay.
This is for the solution of the small volume, the bottle right. of 250, 500 ml. For the bigger volumes, we also provide solution for our customer. We have right now the range of the product that we call T200, T47 and T59, depending on the length of the solution. Okay. But also through the Torrent Group, we can offer to our customer whatever solution is necessary for their needs, including if it's necessary, some solution for very high added value product, very premium product like brandies or very old liquor using the closure in cork. We can also provide many other solutions that we are not producing here, but we can offer as a part of the group.
Okay. You can get it from Spain or somewhere.
Yeah.
What's the kind of investment that you have made in India now, by now?
Well, right now, you know, Alicia Torrent started in 2012 with one line, one small investment. And since then, we have been growing very fast. We move also our original location to another location here near Jaipur. It is in the Mahindra city, in that area. It's a very modern area with a lot of facilities for industries. And from this starting line, now we have in production 7 production lines in our company. Six of them we produce cups for small volume, and also we produce the famous solution T200.
What's the overall production capacity?
As I told you, more than 100 million of the small one. We have more than 10 million capacity by month of the T200 series.
Okay. Is it optimally utilized currently?
Yeah. We have a very high efficiency. One of the key words, elements that we are trying to optimize as much as possible in the Torrent Group is the efficiency.
Okay.
So all of our process, all of our production, maintenance activities, we are looking always for the excellency, and we are looking always to have the maximum efficiency. Along the years, it changed depending on the period of the year,
right.
Months that they are more peak, and another month that they are more valley.
Okay.
And unfortunately, now with this COVID situation, is affecting to our customer. So, well, it's changing everything.
Yes. So right now it's a drop in sales compared to sales to last year.
We are managing. We are managing quite well. But this uncertainty, not for us, but for our customer, to make situation a little bit more complicated. Okay. Normally, this period of the year is not too much production. The peak of the production could be around second half of May, June, first half of July, and after that we have another peak of production, October, November, December.
Yes, the festive season, pre-festive season.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. What is the acceptance of your products in the Indian alcohol market? Because you were one of the last entrants, right? besides AIG? How are your products accepted against competition?
I will say that we have a good share on the markets. Basically, because we, of course, we have our competitors, the traditional one that you know, that is the
very strong,
very much bigger. Not more efficient, but much bigger than us. That is Wada. But we are the second. I'm estimating that we can have around 25-28% of our share on the market is something around 25-28%.
Okay. Okay. And how
we are competing with a huge company as well.
Right. And what's the growth of your coming in now? I mean, COVID situation is a bit abnormal for most of the products. But how is the growth for you in India?
The growth is, so far, has been vertiginous. We have been investing almost every year, improving our process and our machinery. So I can give you later the figures, but we have been since the very beginning in 2012 that we were producing one small amount of production until now. We have been growing every year. I would say that in two digits figures.
Oh, two digits figure?
Yeah.
That's good. You are against strong competition.
Yeah, and also the intention of the company is to consolidate our presence in the Indian market, and also we are exporting our product in the areas of Asia Pacific, in the area, and also in the areas of East and West Africa.
Right, right. But are you planning to have another location within India?
It has been discussed, but not decided yet, because right now we are in, because of our location, we are attending quite well the market in North India, and we have a warehouse working in Chennai, and
right,
we are attending our customer in South India. If we can see that the market is demanding this needs, but perhaps we can consider the option to open another location.
Okay.
So far, and you know, with this pandemic, all the decisions are delayed, everything is not moving natural issue. But we have been studying the option, but so far we need to have some demand from the market to justify this.
Right. What's the USP against your competition?
Let me tell you one thing.
Against competition, yeah.
Let me tell you one thing. In this product, as you know, we have two kinds of products. One is more economic than the other. Both are very economic. But one that we call, it is called Meat Plus.
Mm-hmm.
This Meat Plus has the best result of pull-out result on the market right now, by far.
Okay.
And the advantage of this is that the security anchor ring inside,
right,
if there is any happen of tampering this, removing for any means, you know, that the counterfeiter they use of air, hot water, whatever, they destroy the closure, and it's not possible to make him pay, you know?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
it's not guaranteed to avoid the, it's easy to open, is fitting perfectly the purpose of our customer, and is, if you are trying to tamper it, you destroy it, that is the best. So you can reuse it. Okay? In another product from another competitors, there is, you can find a way to reuse it. With this product, it's impossible. Okay. And regarding our solution, for example, I took this one. This is a T59. Okay.
59. Yeah.
In this case, We have, of course, another excellent result from the pullout. That is something that this is important. The fault that you need for extracting completely this one. And also our valve and system is giving a good pouring rate in normal use. But if you try to refill again, it's almost impossible. It's very, very complicated. So again, with many other possibilities like decorating features and many other things, the features or the performance of our cap at this moment is one of the best in mind. And we have more ideas to improve our products, not only in performance, but also in aesthetic characteristics.
Right. You referred something that you supply to brandy producers in the south, right?
We are trying.
You have different kind of closure for brandy.
We are supplying, and we also are trying to offer them, if they have some premium brand, to offer them a different solution.
So you already started penetrating in the Tamil Nadu business, brandy producers.
We are in contact with everyone. We have contact already with some brandy producers.
We are
in conversation.
Oh, you are in conversation, yeah.
Yeah, but as I told you, with this COVID situation, everything is a little bit slow or slower than expected.
I know.
Close to 25% of the percentage of the business in the market currently you've cornered. So is that, were you referring to India in that percentage?
Yeah. In India, we are with our presence in the market of closure. Is something between 25% to 30%.
Right. So in that 25%, which are the sort of regions where you have more stronghold in terms of your customer base, in terms of whether it's south, north, and so on? Can you just give us a little bit of idea of that?
Our major presence, I will say perhaps something between 65-70% is northern India.
Okay.
And 30-35% in south.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. In the domestic, also we are, as I told you, we are making some export in Asia Pacific, and we're making some export in East and West Africa.
So are you exporting from here, India?
Yeah.
Which part of the world? Which Asia Pacific country?
Asia Pacific, for example, we have been supplying to Vietnam. We have been supplying to, well, now it's complicated. It's stopped because of this political situation, to Myanmar. We have been supplying to Malaysia.
Oh, good.
And also in Africa, we are supplying Kenya, Tanzania, Uganda. South Africa, we started, but now it's a little bit stopped because the situation in South Africa is complicated. And also Nigeria.
Okay.
All this area we are covering from India.
Okay. So export.
We have a factory in Nairobi. So in the area of East Africa, we only offer the big closure. Okay. Not the small one, because we produce also the small one in Nairobi.
Right.
Are the majority of the products that you're supplying are more for premium products, or they are all for the popular sort of categories?
Well, the majority, all we have many different customers. We supply to, of course, to Pernod Ricard. We supply to
Diageo.
To Diageo, USL Diageo. We supply to ABD. We supply to Beam Suntory. But we also supply to Radico Catan, we supply to ADS, we supply in the south to SNG. We also supply to some customers that we have, Jawala Gel, and another customer in Nepal. We have about 30-35. We are supplying all the customers that they are existing in.
What are the sort of challenges that the pandemic situation has put in terms of pressure on your business? That's what he was trying
challenge,
to
challenge. I can tell you that the recent challenge that we are supporting regarding the business, not the commercial activity, is, as you know, suddenly all the prices of all the basic raw material has suffered a strong increase.
Yes, right.
Plastic material like polyethylene, polypropylene, etc. The price of the steel, copper, the auxiliary material, everything has been increasing the price.
Yeah, yeah.
And then this is a challenge because we try to go to absorb as much as possible the pressure of this price increase, and we are trying to don't reflect this to our customers. Some cases we can do it, and other cases, depending on the product, we don't have any option to review the prices. We have an active policy with our customer is to review with them the prices up or down on quarterly basis. No?
Oh, okay. So
the philosophy of Torrent Group is, of course, we need to have, this is a business, so we right. need to have a... Yeah. A profit, a margin, and etc. But we don't want to take advantage of the situation at all. And also, we are completely involved with the business of our customers. Eh? We are there.
It is a difficult situation for you because of petroleum prices has gone up. So, how yes. much you absorbed by now? Every quarter, did you increase it last quarter or this quarter? Are you planning to increase?
We are making some increase in a specific product that we cannot avoid because okay. we are facing losses. Okay.
Okay.
But another product we are maintaining depending on the composition, no?
Uh-huh.
And the influence of the cost. But as I say, in the product that we have reviewed the price, we will review our policy to review the price very frequently. Now we are observing, seems to be that this crazy tendency to increase the of cost of the raw material now is starting to slow down.
Okay.
Slightly reduce a little bit. So we are observing how the raw material market is evolving.
So you may not increase it coming quarter, probably. If this trend continues.
I would like to see how the situation evolves in the next weeks.
Okay. And how is the reaction from the customer?
The customer knows. Because it's not only the grocer, it's only the bottle. It's also the carton from the boxes. The cost of the transport has increased. The cost of shipping has right. increased dramatically. They know. So, but since we are working in this together and we are always working in a very close position to our customers, they understand that this is a difficult situation and we need to distribute the loads
in
both of us. No?
Right, right. What is the trend you see now in the market now, closure market in India? Are the customers similar to Europe or different from Europe and Kenya where you establish your new company?
There is similarities, but there are different. For example, here in India, some kind of, is very popular for many customers to make the decoration, as we call it, hot foil.
Okay.
More than offset. They like more the hot foil. But the design are not complicated. In, for example, in Africa, the customer likes to have a very sophisticated design on the decoration okay. of the closure. Uh-huh. Here is more, it's not so sophisticated. It's more
over.
Elegant, more simple.
Right.
In Europe, it's a little bit different. They are also looking for something not so complicated, so elaborate than, for example, in Africa.
Right, right.
This is for one side. From the other side, you know, now we are suffering is always the question of the discussion. Now you know that the guilty of everything is the plastic.
Right.
I don't want plastic. I don't want to use the plastic. The plastic is like the bad guy of the movie.
Right.
This is wrong. This is wrong because you cannot make general comments about something specifically. For example, you cannot run today one hospital without plastic.
Right.
Impossible.
Yeah.
Impossible. You cannot run many, many businesses without the plastic. Eh? And so you cannot demonize the plastic because it depends on the application and there is a huge variety of whatever is the...
Right.
So in this concern regarding the environment, our closure is something that is perfectly recyclable and we can work on it. It's no problem. Sometimes you know that also Torrey in Spain, they produce the aluminium.
Okay.
In your brochure, I have something here. This is a typical aluminium brochure. Mm. They have plastic elements inside.
Right.
So allow me to say that this one, from the environment, don't be saying, no, aluminium, we can recycle perfectly, whatever. This one is more difficult to recycle than this. That is all plastic.
Okay.
But that is something that is necessary to
but what will happen now?
Explain to the customer, not to our customer, to explain to the population in general, no? That sometimes the solution is to recycle, of course, and the solution is to use in an efficient manner all the consumables that we are using. But they cannot demonize very easily.
Looking at the trend worldwide, plastic may not be there in maybe 20, 25 years from now. They want zero emission.
There is necessary to work with the environment and we need to have a clear solution.
Right.
But there is also many, many politics surrounding everything. Okay.
Yeah.
And sometimes there is some interest, commercial interest, trying to demonize something that perhaps is not so bad or is not so complicated to have the proper use. Allow me to say, in the 80s, the nuclear energy was the evil, was the worst, and especially after the disaster of Chernobyl.
Right.
Now they are talking again about the nuclear energy. Only because Mr. Bill Gates say that there is solution to make the nuclear energy available and safe and whatever. So it was not so bad and not so good. It's something that is necessary to study and see exactly. Nothing is black and white. Everything has different tone of gray. So this is the question. Let me tell you another thing that is very funny. Torrent also provides a good solution, not here, but in Europe, especially in Spain, Italy, whatever, of closure for the olive oil. Olive oil is
an
element, and there are some of our customers, they produce an excellent product there, no? And they want to have some good closure to protect the product. Olive oil, when I was a kid, there was a campaign saying that the olive oil was terrible for health.
Oh.
It was terrible. That was a fat and something terrible that you should avoid olive oil and you have to consume light oil, like the seed oil or whatever.
Right.
I remember, I was a kid there. It was a campaign that lasts for many years. And now all the people know because they have been studying properly that the olive oil is very good for the health because it's giving you the right fats and the not saturated fat, etc. And it is better than another kind of oil that you can use.
Right. So
sometimes I believe that there is hidden interest who manipulate the public opinion.
Yeah.
This. You know what I mean?
Is it? Yeah, I understood. Between two lines, I could make out. Are you developing anything alternative to plastic? Are the efforts at your headquarters on right now?
Yeah, the only thing that we are working is to use plastic, too, and everybody working on it, to use plastic that will be biodegradable.
Biodegradable.
This is the way. Because the war on the plastic is, I mean, nobody knows all the variety of question of plastic. So the idea is to find some solution where you can use the plastic and you can throw away in few months.
Right.
If it has in 1 year, it will be gone.
Okay.
Do you think in the foreseeable future, maybe a couple of decades from now, do you think that there is a possibility that there will be a viable alternative to plastic, or that's really difficult to find in closures, or it will be an extremely challenging task?
The aluminium is the people is not willing for the aluminium. For example, the people sometimes using the aluminium is highly contaminant. Okay, you can recycle, but sometimes because of the lacquer, because of the decoration, and many other things, it's very difficult to recycle. Huh? But also we are producing of aluminium closure. Okay, but. Natural material that you can see the cork, or you can see any other. I don't see any other thing, any other way in future than the used plastic that can be biodegradable in the nature. This is the common agreement that we are experiencing right now. There is nothing else.
And what is the percentage of revenues that are actually allocated towards R&D in terms of your company? Because that, I think, is also very important in terms of future as well, right? For developing newer technology or developing newer closures.
Torrent has a very important center in Spain for research and development. And the Torrent Group dedicates an important part of the revenue. I don't know now the figures. I can give you later. But an important part of this in to investigate and to test new alternatives. The history of the Torrent Group started more than 100 years ago, when the industry of the wine industry in the south of Spain, in Jerez de la Frontera, was one of the most profitable business in the world. Eh? And they started there manufacturing cork closure. Okay. After that, they have been diversifying and making different options, always helping to the customer to close and make open the bottles of the wine, spirits, olive oil, or pharmaceutical industry, whatever is the solution. So we consider that the investigation, we have agreement not only in our internal research and development center, but also we have agreement with different universities and different development center in Spain and the rest of Europe to develop different solutions. Because we need to implement, so we believe, and especially Mr. Torrent believes, that it is extremely necessary always to invest and to develop new alternatives. Yeah. So we believe in this and we are investing on this. I know that this is an important percentage. I don't know exactly the figure that right now, but I will let you know. I will ask him.
Understand. But one in India, then, is the maximum amount of the percentage of the business that is coming for Alisha Torrent, is it only from Alcobev products, or do you also supply to pharmaceutical or olive oil companies, as you were mentioning?
Well,
that those are also
important. We are not supplying other customer because, and we are looking, we have been in contact with some pharmaceutical and other different possible users to offer our solution. But so far, well, we still have some conversation, okay? But so far, the big demand that we have is in our customer who is dedicated to the spirits.
Hmm? But overall, worldwide, Torrent is known for supplying to the alcohol industry, right?
Yes, wine, right. Spirits, alimentary, olive oil,
okay.
and one small part for pharmaceutical.
Okay.
And we are trying to find here some new necessities in the Indian market to see if we can offer something that will be interesting for them.
Okay, so it's a very challenging time for you.
Always. Okay. You're working. No, because when you say you produce, what do? No, I work in a company to produce closure. Seems to me that it's something simple, something not too much attractive or sophisticated. Okay. Allow me to say it's very, very, it's the contrary. It's very attractive, very sophisticated. Okay. You have to challenge with many technical, many issues of different kinds.
And right.
It is very interesting.
In terms of ranking, is Vala Caps number one in the world? Vala Closures number one in the world?
Yes.
And you are number two, right?
Right.
What is that?
By big difference, eh? Keep in mind that Vala has 26 or 27 factories in the world.
Okay, between you.
And in our case, we have four factories in Spain,
uh-huh.
a factory in India, and a factory in Kenya.
Oh, okay. So they are very big.
They are very big. They have been investing some funds. It's not a family.
Uh-huh.
It's not a family business. It's a.
Okay. Vincent, you want to ask anything? Any question?
No.
It's all
right. I have a question. Yeah.
Go ahead.
So, one, as you mentioned just now that after-sales service is an extremely important factor in this industry. So, how would you say that what ranks you ahead of your competition? As you mentioned that you guys are far better in ahead of the competition in that respect.
Okay, let me tell you one thing. Vala is a excellent manufacturer. It is a huge company who also dedicate a lot of effort and money in development. They are very good and they are much bigger than us. But you know, sometimes when you are so big, allow me to say, the risk that you can have is that you lose a little bit of the perspective of the market. And then one thing that we here in Torrent we apply is that we try, only because perhaps this approach to the customer, we try to treat our customer with the best of our effort, no matter if this is Pernod, or it is a very, very small customer who is making effort to make business, etc. We don't care. We are trying to help them. And I insist, we are not, our business is not to sell closure. Our business is to help our customer to prosper and make business, because if they do a good business, we will in the chain. So, but this is our philosophy. Anyone can have their own philosophy. In my opinion, sometimes the only problem that Vala has is not their product, is not their quality, is because they are the size, no?
Right.
Yeah? Sometimes if you are so big, it can be risky. You cannot invite you to lose your perspective. Okay?
Understand. Wanted to circle back to one question. You mentioned in the earlier part of the conversation about the cost of raw materials, which are fluctuating a lot.
Now they are increasing from the last October till now. Right. The increase has been tremendous, has been more than 30%.
Right. So how does that, what is the sort of pressure that is putting in terms of driving the products and estimating the costing? Because is that done more on a quarter basis, or is it done? So say, for example, if you're approaching a customer today in North who's basically looking for you to supply an X amount of product, then how would you estimate that and factor that into the
supply chain? It's difficult. Sometimes we are trying to have a long-term agreement with our supplier to guarantee the prices, quantities, to avoid this kind of health attack. So we try to have some kind of agreement to let's say, shock absorb this. But it's difficult. It's difficult because no matter how efficient we are and how we can squeeze our cost, the raw material is the raw material. The question is that sometimes your margin is this, and sometimes your margin is a fine line. You have to manage this. The only problem that we cannot allow is to run for a long time with a negative margin, because it's not money is a commodity. Money is something that you need to run your business in properly.
Right.
Okay. It's not a matter. So this is not our target to earn a lot of money. No, no. What we are trying is to earn enough money to maintain our business, to make our investment, and to be present in the market, and to create in the community, to create wealth and prosper. This is our target. And we doing what we know very well, is doing closure, manufacturing.
Right. Anything else would you like to say, or should we wrap up?
No.
Okay.
Everything has been improvised. I didn't prepare.
Okay.